Well, tahr hunting as an activity is something that really brought us boys close together, so it's pretty special to the weekend mesh as a group. But unfortunately, since late last June, we've really had some hard times trying to get a big old bull on the deck. So for this season, be it springtime and all the reds have dropped, we thought we'd have a seriously good go at trying to get a nice old boy down. So hopefully we can have some good luck this episode, and let's kick her off.
We're back at it again. It's a couple weekends since the boys last went out. We've got a bit of a different crew this time. It's me, Tomo and Benny. We've actually changed up our plans today. There's a bit of a block behind us that we know there's some good tahr at, but we said, you know what, that's going to be a bit boring. So in weekend mesh style, we're going to go 2 days hard up this catchment behind us and see if we can find a nice springtime bull, or two maybe. And we've also got the bow, so we're real keen to start introducing that theme a bit more and see if we can up our bow skills and get some animals on the deck. But should be a sick one, and hopefully we can have some high action for you. Frothy. Well, it appears that a couple months of uni and getting up to plenty of no good does no wonders for your fitness. So I'm struggling, but these boys are faring well. We've actually done most of the vert for today, which is surprising. And now it's just mostly a shoot down to where we want to camp tonight. We'll probably be in glassing country almost within the next 50 minutes or an hour. So that'll take us, an hour will be about 3 Ks that way. And we're excited. This is a cool hunt.
Benny, mate, you've got absolute fucking wheels of steel on you, mate.
Yeah, I've been practicing my walking skills at home.
Yeah, here's some actual footage of Benny walking before, eh? Like, it's actually insane. Like, look at this dude.
Just stopped for a glass and a bit of water. We're about a K and a half from where we first want to do a really good bit of glassing, where we think we might have a chance of seeing something good. Then we'll push around from there and set up a tent and be properly in the zone by then. It's pretty warm. It's a great day for it though.
Holy heck, a bit unanticipated on the old rock climbing here. Didn't think I'd be getting into this, but you know, 30 kilos on the old back and probably another 50 metres to go on the free climb. Should be good as gold.
Yeah, sweet.
So, we've just spotted the first animal of the trip. Unfortunately, our wind is just ripping up this awesome looking catchment, but so I've got no chance of really holding anything in here, but we've spooked this nice young bull. You know, he's not a monster, but it's pretty sick to see, and hopefully we can pick up some more in here and maybe further up that aren't too winded. Well, pretty classic of this area. We've seen 30 tahr so far, just all nannies and young bulls at the moment, but that's all right. It's real promising, and you know, it's springtime, so they're all those bulls are mobbed up, so we're just hoping that we stumble into our mob of bulls that we're looking for, and hopefully there's a good one or two in there that we can go look at. But yeah, it's looking great, and it's a beautiful day, so glad to be out here in some awesome country.
What's the plan now?
We are going to spend another 5 or so minutes looking up here, and then we're going to punch up this catchment, which is straight that way from me, and pitch a tent, and then do a wee evening hunt, and hopefully find a bull or two to have a look at. But yeah, just loving it.
Looks like you got some black rims around your eyes, mate.
The tent, so I've set our tent up and it's good to know we're gonna set out on our first proper hunt. I've glassed a couple nannies while we've been sitting here. God, that's a weird town. And hopefully we can pick up these bulls we keep talking about, but you know, it's only the first day, first evening, so we're real excited. And the prospect of pushing up this valley a bit further is awesome.
So glass a few more bulls, eh?
Glass a few more bulls.
Glass you, Tom.
Speak, I'm so excited. We've been seeing nannies all day, as we've been saying, and we've just struggled with the bulls so much over the last wee bit, but finally we've found a mob of about 11 bulls in this awesome country. There's got to be one in there, surely. Out of 11 bulls in this catchment, there could be a good one in here. There's got to be a good one in here.
Please.
Please, dear.
Pretty please.
Okay, I'm going to get to assessing. I'll be, this will take me 30 minutes probably. So I've only been assessing this mob for, near on 3 or 4 minutes now. I've panned through most of them. There's a fair share of young ones in there, but there's two there that really stick out to me. And I'd like to just get a good age identification if I can, because we're not far. We're probably only about 800 yards, and we've got the perfect spot to stalk them on. I just can't contain my excitement. This is so awesome. Okay, jump on the binos. Straight up above us there. You can see there's a mob of, so the bulls kind of comprised of like five that are down in the scrub just above like where the scree slope stops out to the right a little bit. And then there's one in there that I looked at that looks like quite a good one. And then there's one that you can just see its ass off to the side of a wee bluff, and it's
just
a bit higher.
Right on,
yeah, right shade. And then if you go up another 100 metres, there's a few nannies. But so if you look through there, and then I'll look through this, and then you can have an assessment and make your judgement as well. Relay info. Alright, Benny, so you know that mob we were talking about? There's five a bit lower, and then like eight or nine a bit higher, but I've just picked one out of the bluffs, and I reckon that's our bull. Same with you, Tomo. I reckon it's a bloody good bull. So,
well, you're shooting it.
Boy, too much bull for me.
Not too big for you, mate.
It's too big for me. This would be seven hundred from here. The old range is struggling a little bit. It's a big golf range finder, not really meant for this nonsense, but what we're dealing with kind of is the big bull we want is about another 150 yards out the back of this big mob of bulls. There's a few maybe 12s, younger animals, maybe one or two shooters in there, but this one out the back, he's the one that I personally really want. But as I was saying, the problem, we've got a Tahr 308, not known for their long range shooting, so we're only really confident out to about 300. So we're gonna have to close this gap with about 16 different eyes on us, but we'll give it a go. You said you were going out. So our stalker pretty much is, keep chipping up this chute. We're lucky because there's a little bit of grass that goes up either side of these scree slopes, and a little bit of matagari and kind of hebe and stuff to conceal us a little bit. So we should be able to close the gap to somewhere where I'm comfortable with shooting with this rifle, and somewhere where we know we can knock down the animal, no harm, no worries, and get the job done. On both sides of the door. Time splits in two on both sides of the door.
guys to come. But they're dropping so quick. They're halving our job at least. So I really, really want to get into a spot where we're nice and concealed, nice and quiet, and can set up that spotter and make sure we get the right one.
What a shame you can't hear me. I speak loud.
Into the middle of the mob. Okay, I'm almost about to have a clear shot now. Okay.
Go for it.
Almost. Yep.
Go for it.
I see one. There, right, there's one there. No, that's young. Did I miss?
I don't think so. Hang on, let me just review real quick. I'll just list it. Tripod there, is that alright? It will be. It'll be fine. Are they still there?
You got them?
No, they're still to come.
Hey?
They're still to come.
Okay.
Okay, no, it's all of them. Alright, no. Yeah.
Go.
Alright. Nah, shot high.
Shot high?
Yeah.
It's still there, still there.
I'm gonna have a go and I'm just gonna aim in a different place.
Yep, do it. Here they go.
Yes! Come on!
That's probably my biggest goal today, so. Insane series of events. We were bloody lucky to get this man on the ground, and it was a bit of a case of average shooting and probably average preparation on our behalf. We had some serious issues with the gun, but I guess we'll fix those, and I think in the future it's the last straw with that rifle of ours. We need to get onto it a bit more and make sure that we're really, really dialed in. Anyway, blessed, insane, what an absolute ripper ball. Probably 6 years old. He's 12 and a half plus. We don't have any measuring apparatus, as we always like to say. And we're unbelievably stoked. This is such an awesome experience. We took a real stab in the dark at coming to the spot, but here we are, and we are just frothing. Absolutely and utterly frothing. I'm just going to aim for the top of the rock and let it drop onto the middle. Shooting soon. It's the next morning after a pretty cool day yesterday, and we've treated ourselves to a wee bit of a sleep-in. Mr. Benny Boy over here has spotted a nice bull above camp, which is pretty cool. Oh, it's, you know, it's a good spot when you can see them walking around just from camp. We've managed to resolve our rifle issues, so we're much more confident coming into today, and hopefully we can get Tomo a bull behind the camera. So yeah, we are very excited, and we'll keep you updated on all our plans for today. The pretty mint thing about these packs is that even though you're taking 80 litres worth of carrying storage, the buckles at the back and then also the fold down kind of dry bag, I don't know, mechanism kind of thing, means that you can pack them down real light to something that more resembles like a 40 litre pack. So when you're doing these day missions from the tent, they're just premium for it. Bloody good. Well, it's that time again. We're about to head off on our first full day. Well, first and only full day actually. But we're going to shoot up the valley. There's a wee corner off in the distance there, probably about a k and a half away, and we'll be around where we saw those bulls last night, so we'll look up into those bluffs, and then if not, we'll just carry on and do some more exploring. There's bound to be a few more big bulls further up this valley, I reckon. So let's get walking. Kia ora. Just parked up on this wee spot where we spotted those mob of bulls yesterday, and we've picked them up again, but only this time they're about 500 yards higher, which is probably what happens when you put a few bullets over their head, but no doubt they'll come back down this evening. We didn't really see many other monsters in there, so we're gonna punch up this valley a bit more, explore some new country, hopefully get onto a new mob of bulls. Maybe go probably another k and a half, 2 k's up that way, and then if we have no luck, we'll come back down and see if we can pick out the biggest one out of that mob and see if Tomo can have a go.
Sat down here for a few hours to let the heat dissipate, let the wind sort of change around a bit. As soon as it did, we saw a few bulls stand up, which was cool. But we're gonna head back down the valley again and try and get onto the mob that we were on last night, so should be fun.
Get your dictionary out when Benny's speaking, because it might be a bit of a battle sometimes.
Big words, mate.
Still a little bit warm. We thought that cloud cover would come over and cool it off, but the sun's still beating down on this face, so we don't want to get too close to these bulls before we can actually see them and see them moving down. So we're probably going to park up for another 30 or 40 and try lay eyes on them before we make a proper push to their location or even a shooting location.
Oh, your mouthful.
Hey, I didn't see you there.
Finish your mouthful. No, finish your mouthful.
Oh, yeah, okay.
There's nothing in your mouth.
No.
Open up. Open up. I want to see.
Well, we'll settle down in our glassing spot now, tucking into some beautiful beef jerky and biltong. And we've picked up that mumble balls we saw earlier, so they're still right up high, but it wasn't until about 6:30 that they started dropping last night. We've also got a wee young bull mucking around a couple hundred yards behind us, which is fun to watch. But it's just as we expected, really. Not a whole lot happening, but you know, we're hoping these bulls come down lower and we can sneak up and have a crack at them.
Do you quite like watching young bulls? Just walking around.
Yeah, love it with a passion. No, Billy Elwood loves it. He'd probably knock that one over behind us, actually. I'm just getting you back for last episode, mate.
What did he say last episode?
Something about me.
Oh, just sitting in your halls. Mm. Wait, so what were you actually doing?
Not exactly that.
Oh, nice.
No, well, had a bit of work to attend to, you know.
Oh, yeah. I know the stuff you're doing.
Oh, no, trust me, I had a few lectures to miss and a few tutorials not to go to. It's pretty important stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So that mob of bulls seems to be moving down as that sun's slowly disappearing. We're going to try to get into position and push up probably about 200 metres up this gut while the sun's in their eyes and we're in the shade. And hopefully they can slowly move down to us over the next hour or so. It's getting a bit cold now, so let's get moving. I think I've just picked up the bull that I spotted this morning on the skyline. So we'll have a quick look and make a decision.
Locked out yesterday, eh?
Yeah. I think we've used up all our lives yesterday.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
All three of them.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Yeah. Oh, well. Pretty eventful night. I'm not sure. Did we show them if those what happened before?
What, after we...
Roughly.
Roughly? What, when we left?
Yeah.
No, we haven't said anything about that.
Okay, well, those bulls actually started coming across that wee snowy face you might have seen. And they were coming into range for sure, but also it was getting a bit dark. And after having a few issues with that rifle, we just weren't comfortable taking a shot out at that range. So decided that those tahr could live for another day and we'd head home a bit earlier, happy and have a good feed and get some rest for our push out tomorrow. But there's potentially still some more action to come tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. But it's been a real cool day and just great to be out here seeing the beautiful Himalayan tahr roaming the hills.
On your mate.
On your mud. Well, our tent's all packed up now and we're going to start making our way down the valley back to the car. However, there are a couple spots where we've been seeing some wallabies and maybe a nanny or two on the way. So there's still a little bit more to come. Stay tuned and a little bit more action. I'm sure Tommy will be out in front with his 3 kilos on his back while me and Benny are battling away doing the real man's work. So let's get into it.
I've got short legs, okay?
So we're in an area that's a wee bit renowned for their Canada geese issues, and we've just spotted a few. And we are under the knowledge that you are able to shoot them on the ground with rifle, and they don't come under, you know, the typical game bird laws. So we've got a couple maybe 200 yards away. We're going to try getting a wee bit closer and see if we can pull one over and get a bit of diversity into the CC at its bank. Do you want to get that out?
You'll get a tough shot, but just have a go. Finish this. Canada down, baby! Yeah, boy!
Far out!
That's sick! That's so sick! Boomtown! I've never been so frothy over a bird in my life. I'm no Billy Elwood, but holy hell, that's good fun.
Oh well, there's certainly plenty more effective ways to get these fellas down than ripping them apart with a big 308, but he was dead quickly and we've really got no other means to do it. So although it's only one, it's one less that's roaming the hills, and it's a wonderful way to finish up our wee walk to the car, because probably about 105 metres away from the car, so
105.
That's pretty cool.
Very specific.
I am very specific. I don't get my distances wrong, right?
Sick.
Well, that concludes the end of episode 4 of season 3 for us. It's been an absolute blinder. We came in here with a goal and we took a couple of risks and we pulled it off. We made it happen. We got a really awesome bull. We'll let you know a bit later on how big that is, because it's going to be a few hours back home until we're able to put the old measuring tape on it. But yeah, awesome. Here's Mr. Benedict Kyle to give you some specs on our distances covered and whatnot.
So we walked 21k, did 1261 metres of vert, and we was hunting for about 18 hours over the 2 days. 2.5 days, so yeah.
Well, we were. Finally, this is a video on YouTube, so we're doing this for you, we're making our content for you guys. Drop a comment below and let us know what you guys enjoy about the channel, what you want to see change, and maybe even the kind of hunts and animals you want to see us chase. If you like what we're doing and enjoying the content, then, you know, like and subscribe, all that weird stuff. It's great for us and we're just loving pumping out this content. Sick. Don't film me for a weird amount of time, it's just makes it weird, champ.
I'm getting shot. Let's go, champ!
Well, that's your fault, you're just wasting the memory card.